We have given 4 different matrices, A, B, C and D, and our task is to calculate every possible matrix product of those 4 matrices. And as a hint, we know that there are 5 different possibilities to multiply those matrices. In order to solve this exercise, we need to know which matrices can be multiplied with each other. The rule for the matrix multiplication states that the number of columns from the first matrix has to match the number of rows from the second matrix. If the matrix on the left side of the multiplication has the dimensions m rows and n columns, then the matrix on the right side of the multiplication needs the dimensions n rows and p columns. Basically, it's only important that the number of columns of the first matrix, which is n, matches the number of rows of the second matrix, which also needs to be n. That is why we start by writing down the dimensions of our matrices. For this exercise, we will assume that the matrices are composed out of real numbers. And the dimension of a matrix can be noted as A is in the real numbers of 3 cross 3. That is because A has 3 rows and also 3 columns. Hence, the dimension of the matrix B is 3 cross 4, because B has 3 rows and 4 columns. The matrix C has 4 rows and 1 column, and D has only 1 row and 4 columns. Now we can use our little rule on the top right to check which matrices can be multiplied with each other. We will start with A, and we now have to find another matrix that has 3 rows. And this is only the case for B. So we know we can multiply A with B. And the order of those 2 factors is important. Let's check out B. So we need to find another matrix with 4 rows, which is the case for the matrix C. That is why we can multiply B with C. C can be multiplied with D because its columns and rows match. And D can also be multiplied with C. At this point, we have found 4 different multiplications, but from our task, we know that we need to find 5 in total. So the one we have forgotten is that we can multiply A with itself, because the columns and rows match. Let's get started by multiplying A with B, which is this matrix multiplied by this one. To multiply matrices, we have to imagine that we go through the rows of the first matrix from left to right. So from this side to this side, and through the columns of the right matrix from the top to the bottom. And the size of the solution of our multiplication is the number of rows from the first matrix and the number of columns from the second matrix. So in our case, it's 3 cross 4. So let's start with the top left element of our matrix. To do this, we have to go through the first row of our first matrix and the first column of our second matrix. Take 1 and multiply it with negative 1. Then we will go on to the next item, which is negative 1 times 0, and we will just add it, so plus negative 1 times 0. And then we also have 2 times 1. And those 3 summons represent the top leftmost entry of our final matrix. The next entry in our final matrix is really similar, but this time we will use the second column of our second matrix. So we will start by multiplying 1 with 0, then adding negative 1 times 1, and then 2 times 0. For the third column, we have 1 times 1 plus negative 1 times 0. Plus 2 times negative 1. And the last column of our first row is 1 times 0 plus negative 1 times negative 1 plus 2 times 0. This is the first row of our final matrix, and now we need to repeat those steps for the second and the third row. So the second row starts by multiplying 0 with negative 1. Then we have 3 times 0 and 5 times 1. The second column will then be 0 times 0 plus 3 times 1 plus 5 times 0. Then we have 0 times 1 plus 3 times 0 plus 5 times negative 1. And the last column is 0 times 0 plus 3 times negative 1 plus 5 times 0. Now we will continue with the last row, which starts by multiplying 1 with negative 1 plus 8 times 0 plus negative 7 times 1. Then we have 1 times 0 plus 8 times 1 plus negative 7 times 0. In the third column we have 1 times 1 plus 8 times 0 plus negative 7 times negative 1. And the last column is 1 times 0 plus 8 times negative 1 plus negative 7 times 0. As a last step we can simplify those terms. So in the top left corner we get negative 1 plus 2, which is 1. Then in the second column we have just negative 1. Here we have 1 plus negative 2, which is negative 1. And in the last column we have just 1. For the second row we have a 5, a 3, a negative 5. And the last column of the second row is negative 3. For the last row we have negative 1 minus 7, which is negative 8. Then we have 8 and 1 plus 7, which is also 8. And in the bottom right corner we have negative 8. And this is our final matrix of A times B with 3 rows and 4 columns. We will now continue with B times C, which are those two matrices. And again we will go through the rows of the left matrix from left to right and through the columns of the right matrix from top to bottom. So we have negative 1 times 1 plus 0 times 0 plus 1 times 8 plus 0 times negative 7. And for the second row we have 0 times 1 plus 1 times 0 plus 0 times 8 plus negative 1 times negative 7. And our last row is 1 times 1 plus 0 times 0 plus negative 1 times 8 plus 0 times negative 7. And if we simplify this matrix we get negative 1 plus 8, which is 7. In the second row we have 7. And in the third row we have 1 minus 8, which is negative 7. And this is our final matrix of B times C. And this matrix has 3 rows and only 1 column. Because B has 3 rows and C has 1 column. Since with C times D we are having only one column in C and only one row in D, we get simply 1 times D as the first row, so we can simply copy D as our first row, which is 1 times negative 1, 1 times 2, 1 times 0 and 1 times 8. For the second row we are multiplying everything by 0, that is why our second row is just 0, 0 and 0. For the third row, we are multiplying everything by 8, which gives us negative 8, 16, 0 and 64. And in the last row, we are multiplying everything by negative 7, which results in 7, negative 14, 0 and negative 56. And that's the solution for C times D, which has 4 rows and 4 columns. For D times C we can nicely see that the matrix multiplication isn't commutative because we get negative 1 times 1 plus 2 times 0 plus 0 times 8 plus 8 times negative 7. And this is only one row deep and one column wide. So our result is just a 1 by 1 matrix with the entry negative 57. And for our last multiplication, which is A times A, I've just noted down the result. And if you'd like, you can try it yourself and then check your answer.